हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल खत्री स्टेनो। सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल फॉर मोर डिक्टेशंस ऑन डेली बेसिस। गेट रेडी। द पिटिशनर इन द इंस्टेंट पिटिशन हैज़ प्रेड फॉर डायरेक्शंस टू रेस्पोंडेंट नंबर टू टू अलो हर द बेनिफिट ऑफ मैटरनिटी लीव एंड परसुएंट टू दैट ग्रांट हर रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ अटेंडेंस फॉर कंप्लीटिंग द मास्टर ऑफ एजुकेशन विद इन ब्रैकेट एमएड कोर्स। The petitioner has also prayed for directions to respondent number 1 University Grants Commission within bracket UGC to frame specific rules and regulations for the grant of maternity leave for postgraduate and undergraduate courses. Learn counsel appearing on behalf of the petitioner submits that the petitioner was enrolled in December 2021 for pursuing the 2-year MAD regular course from respondent number 2 university. On 28-2-2023, the petitioner received a reply from the dean of respondent number 2 whereby her request for maternity leave was denied. The petitioner thereafter raised her grievance before respondent number 1, and since the petitioner did not receive any response, she has approached this court for the aforesaid directions. Learn counsel appearing on behalf of the petitioner states that respondent number 1 UGC in terms of circular dated 14-12-2021 made provisions in the UGC bracket minimum standards and procedure for award of MPhil / PhD degrees bracket close regulations 2016 bracket hereinafter UGC regulations 2016 bracket close providing for women candidates to avail maternity leave / child care leave within bracket CCL once in the entire duration of MPhil / PhD course for up to 240 days. He therefore submits that the respondent number 2 should also be directed to make the necessary provisions for providing the sufficient days of leave towards maternity leave / CCL. Learn counsel for the petitioner has placed reliance on various 3 decisions in the cases of Soumya Tiwari versus State of UP and others delivered by the learned single judge of the High Court of Allahabad and a decision passed by the High Court of Judicature at Madras dated 9-7-2012 in A. Arulin Ajitha Rani versus State of Tamil Nadu to reiterate that the petitioner cannot be denied the benefit of maternity leave solely on the ground that no provision exists in the statute, ordinance or regulations applicable to the university for such an act would be a violation of the petitioner's fundamental rights under Article 14 within bracket 3 and 21 of the Constitution of India within bracket hereinafter Constitution. The Constitution as adopted on 26th of November 1949 served as a pledge that the citizens of India made to themselves, a pledge to disassociate ourselves from the parochial notions of society that prevented the ushering of equality. It was without any form of equivocation that the people asserted their right to be treated equally. Irrespective of gender, race, religion, or caste, citizens were to claim their opportunities. The Constitution envisaged an egalitarian society where citizens could exercise their rights and the society as well as the state would allow the manifestation of their rights. A compromise was then not sought in the constitutional scheme. The citizens could not be forced to choose between their right to education and their right to exercise reproductive autonomy. A man could then well enjoy parenthood while pursuing his higher education, whereas a woman necessarily has to undergo pre- and post-pregnancy care. It is not her choice, but the will of nature.